This is FFPÖ, your primary source for Austrian film and TV critique, where two minds come together to take apart the work of people who actually matter.
Welcome back to a new episode of FFPÖ. I'm your host, Paul, and this is the 10th episode on the 8th of September 2016. And we have a lovely new co-host with us. It is
Julianna Meagher.
Hello, Julianna.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
You're
thanks
welcome.
Thanks for stopping by. So just quickly introduce yourself. Tell us what you do, what you're up to, and then we'll continue to the main topic.
I'm Julianna. I speak too softly sometimes. I'm a stand-up comic. I do comedy in New York, and I work at Citibank during the day because I like watching people kill themselves in front of me with Excel. Microsoft Office kills a lot of people.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, the overexcitement at the 2016 Microsoft Excel campaign was too much. There were like overexcited people
on
the
surprised.
Posters. Yeah.
Oh my, the spreadsheets.
Yes, they are too powerful.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and we watched The Dark Valley, or as it is known in the German speaking country, Das finstere Tal. It is just describe what you got out of it, out of the whole experience.
There's a lot of snow and rape symbolism.
Right.
And there's some blood on snow, which I think goes with that.
Oh yeah, right. Yeah,
yeah.
That's an added. Yeah, that's your main takeaway from the
much,
whole movie.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
And they like doing a lot of very close up shots with very blurry backgrounds.
Right. Yeah.
Very
that's
intense.
Yes. Yes.
Very
a lot
intense.
Of bokeh.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of wide angle shots.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Totally.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A typical Western in its feel. But with modern cinematography, and also the bane of all modern films, that you try to overproduce everything.
Yes, and dry clean everyone's clothes.
Oh yeah. Nobody's really dirty. Even the dirty people are not really dirty.
Yeah, that was interesting. The dead guy, even I was like. Some very, very sharp.
Which dead guy? There are a bunch of dead guys.
Smash with the log.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So we're going to go to our first point of business.
Mm.
And that's going to be plot. I'm going to fix that in post. And just, you know, whatever. Just tell us quickly about the plot, what you got, what you took away from the plot from this movie.
Took away from the plot. There was an American who came to the mountains. There was a
yeah,
lot of
in
snow.
The Tyrolean Alps.
Yes, I didn't know that part, but you did say it.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was an American who came, very suspiciously, very well dressed, and there was a girl that really seemed like they were going to get it on. That never happened. But the main plot.
That was a good misdirection.
I was impressed, actually. I was pretty impressed.
Yeah, yeah. And he never kissed the girl.
I was very impressed.
Yeah.
And I assumed he was going to murder, like, the pussy boyfriend, husband, fiancé, and then just, like, sleep with her. But he didn't.
Lucas.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Lucas is a pansy name, so.
Yeah, but he was very handsome.
Oh, yeah. He would
but
be.
But, yeah, I agree.
Good-looking fellow.
So, to the plot, though, he came, he met a very, very weird group of mountain people who were ruled by, like, some very
that
obvious...
That sounds so offensive to us.
Well, it wasn't the fact that they were Austrian, it was more the rapey part that
made
them mountain people.
Yes, exactly.
They were ruled by a kingpin, which is not really how I would... But I guess, I mean, it's accurate. I just think of it as Duck Dynasty, I guess.
just current U.S. redneck behavior.
I wouldn't put that on rednecks.
Oh, okay.
Rednecks.
Just in general.
Just.
Yeah, that's a certain subgroup of Americans.
Very weird. Yeah, just I guess rapey gentlemen.
Yeah. Rapey gentlemen.
Well, they had such nice facial hair.
Oh, yeah. No, they were down with the beards.
Very. He comes, he sees there's some very unsubtle notions of this young girl who's going to get married. Something terrible is going to happen.
Oh yeah, they're hitting the hay, like him, she
oh,
and Lucas.
That was,
Yeah, and she actually is the whole, you know, not having a condom and not being still, you know, in very Catholic Christian times.
I had a bit of a problem. I mean, not.
Okay, tell me how. Yes, your issue.
I've had.
Oh, you have so many notes, by the way.
I do have
okay,
a lot of
please,
notes.
Listeners,
I
you
do
have.
Wanna,
you
do
don't see this. You didn't see this, but. Julianna took down the most notes that ever anybody took down during an episode of it.
Six and a half pages.
It's still letter
it's
size.
It's my rule.
But yeah.
But I did write. Okay, I have to say that I have. This is how I kind of marked the notes. Is that I at every point when she started, I just wrote, "Bitch, stop narrating." but then there was one point towards the end where I wrote, "Bitch, it's actually okay that you're narrating," because that was when we didn't understand what was happening, and I was like,
"Oh yeah,
this
yeah,
is good."
Yeah, yeah. She
and then at the end, I was like,
stuff.
"No, bitch, stop narrating."
Yeah, the film suffers from over narration.
She didn't need to narrate almost any of that.
No, they could have.
I was very kind of concerned and disappointed by that. I don't understand. I don't.
Maybe it's because that normally, in that way, doesn't happen in Austrian movies, at least as I know.
Okay.
Like, we like narration, but not to the extent that they did it in this movie.
A lot, yeah.
So, I'm thinking, because they clearly targeted this to the American market, with the Western theme and
the English credits.
Yes, the American actor.
Yeah, the hero being American
saving
all the women and children from the bad native Austrians.
Yeah.
That was kind of, I was a little taken, it came off as actually a little imperialist, like,
we're gonna come back to that, I have noted that down as a separate point.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, but it's clearly targeted to be like, again, Oscar material, I guess.
Mm. Specifically Oscar, best foreign film.
Yeah, exactly. Which it did get nominated for, so good job, I guess.
They did it very well.
Yeah, so yeah, they hit the genre, like,
yeah,
on the
very
head.
Very well.
They had the songs.
Do you know who won for this for that category? Because they didn't win.
No, they didn't, but I'm looking it up,
there,
like,
I'm,
right
gonna,
now.
I'm gonna, I'll look here, you can... Are you?
Yeah, I'm gonna do that,
okay.
And you
curious,
and you continue with the plot, so...
Oh, yeah, sorry, so the plot.
Right, we don't want to get lost in your notes.
There's so many.
Yeah, there's so many. So what was the next thing? He comes to town.
He comes to town. There are a lot of close-ups on everyone's complexion.
Yeah,
it's very consistent.
Yeah, it's a L'Oreal thing, I guess.
I don't know if it was that positive. I told you I had some of my notes on plot were more like questions. So his daughter, for the people who haven't seen it, the girl. There. The stranger comes to town, the American, nobody likes him, everyone is very suspicious, he gives them money, they're like, this won't cover the winter, whatever that means.
Mm.
And then something changes, they agree, they
they just were, you know,
it was enough money,
overcharging.
Yeah,
they were just overcharging.
He gave them enough money, and then they bring out...
Like, any money in that mountain town is, like, fucking...
I know, I had to wonder, like...
Like, the most currency that went through it was, like, through one guy.
Yeah.
And the rest of the mountain people just traded between themselves most of the time.
Yeah, I would assume.
So money in any currency and any form. And it was gold American coins.
Right, which is a whole other, yeah.
That's just, you know, cash money right there.
Well, yeah, literally. So that happens, they acquiesce, you know, they're like, okay, cool. And then they get, I know I'm just saying this a lot, but they get, like, very rapey with the young girl for no clear reason. That was a little confusing at the beginning, like, it made more sense later on when it was clearly a theme. But at the beginning, she looks so, like, stern and frigid with her very down-the-middle haircut. Like,
oh, yeah, she's so symmetrical.
All of the guys have amazing hair in
this,
and all of the women look terrible. I think that's accurate.
That might be historically accurate, actually.
That's very possible, but the guys do look like they have hair gel.
it's lard back then. Definitely
that's
lard.
That's fine, but...
Yeah.
So she comes out looking very severe, and they like this guy who they like previously were threatening to kill. They're like, yeah, take
one
really
second. We'll be right back. Sorry again. And we're back. Sorry for that small interruption, but we had to get our plot fixed, I guess.
That doesn't translate well.
Oh yeah, that's yeah. I guess so.
Where were you? Okay, you have to help me out. Remind me, because this.
Okay, so
it was your fault. So you've got to reorient.
Okay, so he arrives back into town.
For the first time.
For the first time. Well, technically, only for the first time. She was
pregnant. Don't give it away.
All right. Really, it's a 2014 movie. Plot twists and everything are already, you know, spoiler. This is spoiler zone.
I wondered on record that he saw this for the first time tonight, so this is him talking out of his ass.
Yeah, I'm totally talking out of my ass.
But
that's 90% of the time.
So reorient.
I have
reorient.
An ass face.
Reorient.
Yes. Okay. So, Rape Town Central. He arrives back
into town.
Yes, and there is he's just
meets the girl.
Yes, trying to stay for the winter. They overcharge him,
mm-hmm.
and then
kind of threaten his life a little. But
yes, exactly. And he's staying with one of the young
woman and her youngish daughter. It's kind of been
exactly
clear how old she is, but I imagine is it on purpose?
Yeah.
She's somewhere between. I mean, she's clearly at least 15 and clearly under
18, 19, maybe.
Yeah. I mean, clearly,
again,
in the context of the movie, she's obviously under 18.
Yeah.
If I just saw her in real life,
oh,
I'd be
actress,
like, she could be 20, 20, 20.
The actress is definitely older.
But it just like,
yeah.
If it weren't for this, if it weren't a period movie, I'd be like, oh, she could be 20, 21.
Right.
But you're right, yeah. No, there's no way she's that age. Or she's in that time period. Yeah, so he's with her. She has a very, like, very stark personality change back and forth. She's so frigid and cold, which maybe is because of the Brenner brothers, who are they practice, what is that term? There's a Latin term for it when you actually a thing in the medieval times, but it was people told stories about it and it became like
That you lay
legend.
With the wife,
it's a certain kind of rite.
Well, right. I should know that as a historian, but I should. But actually, it did happen in medieval times, but it was so rare.
But there were no. I mean, I'm sure that it did happen, but there were. Aren't there no like credible.
There's no direct sources.
Yes,
there's
direct
just,
sources.
Just indirect.
I'm sure it did happen because obviously, like,
yeah,
somebody,
if you have that
somebody
much
would
power
do that. Of course, like,
with,
somebody
with
would do
repercussion,
that. Of course, I'm sure. I mean, kings obviously did that unofficially. Like,
well, again, kings were too much of not of a regional thing, so they had more of a pick and choose kind of vibe.
That's fair.
And we're talking more like of a count or something.
Fair.
Like somebody who is more regional.
Yeah, no, you're right. Yeah, very good point.
Because like the Austrian king ruled so much of our land at some point that it was already hilarious, and then he renamed himself a Kaiser. So.
Well, by Austrian king, who are you referring to?
Yeah, well, like Rudolf the Fourth, for example, who also was emperor of the Holy Roman Empire at some point.
I would refer to him as an emperor before or before.
Yeah, but that's his main title actually is the Austrian kingdomship, and the other one is just, you know, oh, by the way, we're gonna add this to the stuff that you, because he was, you know, you pick and choose the emperor.
I know you're right, but in America, we probably call him the Holy Roman Empire.
All right. Yeah, which was neither holy nor Roman nor an empire.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, good stuff.
Mm. I took European history too.
Ah, very good. Excellent.
Well,
excellent.
It's not that impressive.
Really, it's just
really
an introductory
just
class? Or?
Yep, pretty much.
There are a lot of different countries. They had war constantly.
Hey, there are a lot of different countries. The borders changed so many times. Like, don't even bother learning them.
That's true even for Austrian history. For like.
Oh, I know it's true for Austrian history. I know it's true for Austrian history.
Yeah.
My professor was, my teacher was very obsessed with the 30 Years' War.
Oh, yeah, that was a good time.
That was
so many people died.
So many people.
And It's so stupid too.
For so few reasons.
Yeah. Okay. So.
So yes. Back on the plot.
Okay. So, but I actually looked it up. So.
And what is it called?
No, I didn't look that up. I looked up who won the foreign film Oscar
that
year, and it was apparently La Grande Bellezza. It's an Italian movie. So they won.
What was it about? I don't really know.
It's.
Does it have a log line or no?
Fuck.
It's fine.
Somebody's partying a lot. And he's 65.
Cool. Okay. Makes sense.
Yeah, and he has apparently maybe some kind of midlife crisis, I'm guessing.
Way too old for midlife crisis, but alright, cool. alright.
Yeah.
So we go back. So the girl, very frigid, then suddenly she has this fiance-ish person.
Oh, and before that, she actually got recast for being too nosy. Like, they introduced her.
First she was not friendly enough.
Mm-hmm.
And then she asked him too many questions. She got very friendly with him. She was so cold to him.
Yeah, but I'm thinking just
the
magic box helped.
True.
So for the listeners, the magic box in this case is a camera that American brought. Yeah, and back then, you know, freaking magic, you know, in a mountain town. Without trying to paint something, just have a few seconds, have an actual picture.
Very true.
Yeah. So
very true.
That was just amazing technology.
True.
Yeah.
So he has that, and that does, like, I'm sure that, I mean, that clearly it impresses and bonds her, but she gets, she becomes very, very forward and just.
Maybe because the guys weren't here.
I mean, I'm sure it was very much.
Because the Brenner boys are just intimidating as fuck.
They are, but she came off as almost. I mean, I think you're. I mean, I'm sure you're right, but she came off as almost overplaying it to the point of.
Oh yeah.
Of.
Total.
Because
submission,
even when they were not. No, the opposite. Actually,
okay.
I thought she was not very submissive.
Oh,
but
because
she was
resisting the hand grab, for example.
Yeah, I thought she and well, I mean, the weird thing to me was. Once he comes inside, once the Brenner boys are gone, because they are obviously the force.
Yeah.
She comes inside, they come inside, and she refuses to make his bed.
Right, yes.
And they're not there. Nobody is watching except her mother.
That's true, yeah.
That was, to me, I was like...
Yeah, I was just thinking, bad hotel service right there.
Like,
he paid so much money, and he doesn't, like, one star on Yelp.
It's not like she got paid money, but yes.
Oh, back then it was probably Yodel, and it just they cried it over the, like,
I'm sure.
Bad service, one star.
But I thought that was interesting, because I agree that I was unsure, I didn't feel very confident in the conclusion about her, because it was in front of them, but that was the one event, that was a very clear, I mean, clearly, her mother reprimanded her, it was a very defiant gesture. God, not making beds, goodness, how far we've come.
Yeah, exactly.
But I did think that was interesting that that seemed personal against him.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next day she was very inquisitive, excited about his life and asking him all sorts of questions, which she got reprimanded for.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. So after that let's speed this up because there's so much plot.
It's so dense.
Like we have a bunch of exciting murders in the first 50 minutes, mm-hmm. like, especially the second one. The first one was tense, but the second one
first
was exciting.
The first one seemed a very plausible accident.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
So the guy got killed in a logging accident. It's
exactly.
The whole story.
Yeah, that's what happened.
That's what it appears,
yeah. exactly. But the second one was, the snow is here, winter is here, and one of the Brenner boys is out hunting,
mm-hmm.
and he noticed somebody in the woods,
mm-hmm.
or something in the woods that spooked the deer,
mm-hmm.
and he follows the tracks, and then gets...
Like everyone in every good horror movie.
Yeah, he get... Yo, that was a horror movie scenario.
It was very played.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he was like the poor victim.
Yeah.
And he gets sidelined by a branch,
mm-hmm.
filled with nails.
Yes.
Oh, so good.
With horseshoe nails.
Which
Greider?
Greider?
You should know how to pronounce it.
Greider.
Greider, thank you.
Greider, with an
I
R.
I probably could have known.
G-R, Greider.
Greider, okay.
Yeah, not bad.
He asked for those earlier very prominently.
So yeah, exactly.
It was very clear.
Well, I didn't think of it as much because I was just assuming him in the innocent role.
Wait, oh,
and then he's just
yes.
getting victimized and then he's just starting to kill people.
Okay, yes, agree.
Yeah.
Agree.
Yeah, so.
But
so
it was a clear, whether you thought it was a very obvious misdirect or a very obvious direct, either way,
yeah,
it was
it's well done.
Drawing attention,
yes.
Either way.
Yeah, and yeah, he gets a handful of nails in his face, two of them land in his eyes.
Yeah, very, very nice.
And he then falls down a mountainside.
Which I thought was unnecessary. I just didn't understand why that was necessary.
It kind of reminded me of the hot rod scene, the first movie from the guys from The Lonely Island. They made a movie back in 2006 or something called Hot Rod, and they had a scene where he fell down a mountainside for like 50 seconds or something. Yeah, and I was like, yep, that's basically the same thing right now.
I did very much like though that I was impressed and pleased with the shoot. I thought they did a pretty decent job of shooting out of his eyes after he'd had the nose.
Oh yeah,
with the
smeared
lens. Yeah, it was ballsy. It was.
Yeah, that was big, really well done.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the falling
it
down was.
But I was impressed that they tried it and they didn't do it terribly.
So after those two accidents, they finally kind of.
After that one.
Yeah.
Because they pulled the nail out of his eye. And
yeah,
then
and then.
Like,
oh, yeah, right.
Then
who
it's very Tony Soprano.
Who bought the shoe nails?
Yeah, it gets very Tony Soprano after that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And they ride out and don't find him.
Yeah, despite the fact that they know this place, like their ancestors have lived there. And
yeah, exactly. And they're a gang.
And just also.
They never show the American side. Like he's always the ominous force that just appears.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's like Batman.
He's kind of a Batman.
Yeah,
he's like Batman mixed with Jon Snow from Game of Thrones. That's
yes.
What I would say.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, and he just appears out of nowhere, and just.
Jon Snow is a very American figure in Game of Thrones.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
The bastard.
Yeah.
Very American.
That still made his way.
Very,
the American way of life.
He is the American. Jon Snow is the American in Game of
Thrones.
And
it ends up at the wall. But, yeah, well, potatoes.
Yeah.
They ride out. They try to hunt him down. There's they still want to push the wedding.
Right, yes. It's very consistent. It is unclear. I give them credit for that. That does build tension quite a bit for the audience. But it's very unclear. They're so upset. These two young kids who are in love, they're so upset that they're getting married.
Yeah.
They're like, we want to be married so badly. And then they're sobbing over the fact that they're being told that they have to get married.
Yeah, also,
that's
yeah.
Good. It's good. That's
yeah,
good. Yeah,
that was good. Very well done,
yeah,
I think.
I
yeah,
I appreciated that.
Yeah, and it was made clear later on with the narration what actually was going on.
Well, they didn't need the narration, but yes.
Yes.
Yes, but yes.
Okay, so there's a wedding going on, and the Greider shows up at the wedding, or so we think.
It looks like he's going to. He doesn't. They're already married.
Yeah. They are gone, and
he comes. He kills the priest. He confesses.
But he confesses first. Yes, exactly.
Well, he confesses to the murder of two of the Brenner boys.
Yeah.
And then he kills him, and there's a very eloquent flashback of his mother.
Yeah. And what happened to her and his father and all. Well,
his father refused, or his potentially.
Yeah.
It's
unclear.
His
Joseph.
His mother. Yes. Yes. Very well said.
Yeah.
Very well said. His Joseph. His mother's. Husband.
Yeah, exactly. Soon to be husband, in this case.
They didn't get. I don't know.
Yeah.
They did get.
They
got married, but they hadn't consummated the marriage.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sealed the deal.
Right.
Oh, so to say.
That's where they.
Yeah. yeah. I know. So just wanted to be.
I know.
Oh, thanks. All right.
Yes. So, flashback. Essentially, his father was like the one guy who stood up to Brenner, old man Brenner, said, "No, you can't rape my wife." He was like, "I'm gonna crucify you."
Yeah.
They ran away. They found them. An innkeeper with kind of Jewish overtones, which was uncomfortable for me as a Jewish person living in Austria.
But you know,
Marie Meagher eat the gold coins. Technically, a little bit.
The innkeeper. Yeah, that's
right.
Is that whole thing basically?
I'm just saying.
Yeah, no. I get it now. But, you know, the percentage of Jewish people in rural Tyrol was next to nothing.
But if they were there, wouldn't they be innkeepers?
Oh, yeah.
Who
probably.
Would do
no, no, they were actually, they weren't allowed by law to be innkeepers.
Oh,
they can only handle with money, basically, like banks and stuff.
Oh.
Yeah. Yay! Cool!
Great, okay, so
yeah.
This is not that.
But still, the metaphor still stands, especially if you're American,
and if you don't
know the context, then you probably just assume that those are two Jewish people.
I mean, I didn't actually assume that they were Jewish until I was talking about it just now.
Ah, okay,
but
right.
It fit really well when I realized, I was like, oh, eating the gold coins, that seems like it.
Yeah. But again, American dollars back then were made
honestly, the movie didn't actually portray it that way at all.
Yeah, but still.
It would be, yeah, it's very American.
You can interpret that into it.
It's an easy jump to make, but the movie doesn't really encourage it in any way.
Yeah, okay, so the Brenner boys... Finally, they have their wedding party where it gets really weirdly
rapey.
Yes,
I think
dance moves.
I think about dude, why so rapey?
Dude, why so rapey?
Followed by, where are they even getting the cowboy hats?
Oh yeah, those hats. They
those
must
be American hats.
Yeah, but again, those were worn by Austrians, I think, too. Like.
Some of them did not seem.
Yeah, they.
Some of them were very broad brimmed.
Yeah.
I was like, "There's no sunlight. There's no reason you need that. You don't need to cover
true,
your neck."
True. Actually, we should have watched it with the English dubbing, just to see if they are like Texans or something.
I'm sure that they played them British, as all Americans play everyone in Europe.
Yeah. It's not just a bunch
everyone
of British
in
people.
Europe, all the Nazis were. All the Nazis went to Eton and Oxford. Like,
yeah,
that's
very much true, and their German accents are hilarious.
They're British. That's how. I mean, that's how Germans were in World War II, right? Like,
yeah, they were just British.
They took a break.
Yeah. Just. We are not talking the German accent anymore.
No.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Goodness. So they are married. There's a very intimidating dance scene. Her very.
Yeah.
He's very beautiful, but very.
Scrappy.
Yeah, he would be an English schoolboy.
He's very
handsome.
Yes. Yeah.
Very.
In the gay scene, he would be the twink.
Yes.
Yeah.
In the straight scene, he would be the twink. I mean, don't get me wrong. I would have him. Like, trust that.
Yeah.
That's not, it's not an issue.
Yeah.
So he tries to fight back, and she reassures him, "Don't do that. I would rather, you know, be raped than have a dead husband," which is fair.
Yeah.
They take her, and then the American
shows up again, out of nowhere,
guns blaring from a great angle.
Isn't it guns blazing?
Yes, thank you.
Guns blaring.
It's really sad that I was just corrected by it, but that's bad.
I'm studying English, so
no, there's no excuse.
There's no excuse.
All
right.
Guns blazing, apparently.
Guns blaring. I love that. That's great.
Guns.
Yeah.
Up or whatever. He shoots them, and see, to me, this is when the climax actually happens. When
threatening them
and
taking away the girl.
Yeah, he lets them go, and I actually thought that was the climax.
Right, because
he challenges them to duel in the English. I don't know what it was in German, but in English, the actual translation was after sunset.
Yeah.
What was it in German?
Nach dem Sonnenaufgang, which means after the sunrise, like at sunrise.
At sunrise, in any duel, that's very common to say at sunrise.
Yeah.
Pistols at dawn is a common.
Yeah. The translation is wonky at some points.
I mean, it's a very specific, but that in particular, just a very specific. I don't think that anyone has ever challenged someone to duel after sunrise.
Right. Yeah.
That's
a hippie shootout. That's a hippie shooter. Yeah, man. Like sometime during the day, just come by, drop by.
Like, which is kind of what they do. But
yeah.
So
just go with the flow when you have to shoot.
That was the climax when the girl gets on the white horse.
Yeah.
That was a bit much.
Yeah, and also.
Didn't think that was necessary, but it was. Yeah, you know, but I thought the scene in general was fine. But I thought that was the climax, and I didn't really...
Also, if somebody like Quentin Tarantino did it, there was like something that spooked somebody, there was a shot fired, and then just a whole massacre going on.
Right, which is how real massacre work.
Yeah.
I have to say, I did think I was at the 30 minutes to the end, I was like, this could be done.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, and it just goes on and on and on.
Yeah.
But
it's not such a long movie, it's not even 2 hours, but I was just like, it could be done.
She gets dropped off, and he reassures the villagers that the village people that he's gonna
kill the brother.
Yeah, exactly, and gonna meet them on an open field instead of meeting them at their house, which would be disastrous because they don't know how to fight, apparently.
Right.
Yeah. So he hides out in a little blockhouse.
Yeah.
They find him, and then the real climax happens, which is, I guess, a pretty well done shootout.
It's very well done as a shootout. Well done as a shootout.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I enjoyed it very much.
The big under the floorboard trick.
Yes.
Very good.
Nice.
Very
nice. That was what made it very Quentin Tarantino for me. It really reminded me. It was a kind of a couple, like it was a compilation of that first scene in Inglourious Basterds.
Yes.
But a bunch of Quentin Tarantino scenes. It really, really reminded
me.
And the fact that at the end there's blood on the snow, I was like, this does.
Yeah.
This rings very.
Yeah.
Tarantino.
Yeah, and
classy. It's like classy Tarantino. That's Austrian.
True. and the American really, really pulls his weight. And just massacres them.
A very, very. You're gonna go Western. I was almost a little bit disappointed in that. It's an Austrian Western, but the hero is an American.
Yeah, I know.
It's.
Again, pandering, I guess.
I mean, but it's.
They could have replaced him with a guy who just went to Vienna or something and came back.
They could have, but it would have. I mean, I do think it would have had a different. The ending, him. Well, we'll get there, I guess.
Yeah. So we have the shootout. He kills all the Brenner boys because he actually.
These American boys are great at
shooting. Yeah, and his Winchester. In his Winchester rifle is just. So overpowered.
American guns are great.
Exactly.
Because America and guns and
freedom
Our boys are fantastic, and those European guys are creepy as hell.
Best foreign film. Tobias Moretti shows up. He's like a very famous Austrian actor. He actually, and that's the really funny part. He's mostly known to be a hero figure. Like he's cast mostly as a hero because his breakout role was a buddy cop TV show with a dog called Kommissar Rex, and Rex was the dog. Like the title of the TV show was the dog, not the main character. Yeah. So that was his first role. So I was really surprised to see him as like the villainous asshole kind of guy, and so that was amazing casting on their part. So he kills all of them because he has just more bullets. That's it basically.
It's very America.
Yeah.
It's weird, honestly. Like watching it, I was like, I almost felt like it was a more clever theme. The fact that at the very beginning you have the credits, it's an Austrian movie, it's in German. Everything is in German.
Yeah.
But the very beginning, they give you this lovely like foreshadowing.
Yeah.
Because the credits are in English, and all the people, and it's the credits are even
and
the
song
are
and the song is in English.
Yes, exactly. And the companies even like when it's showing the credits, the production companies are in German.
Yeah.
It's all in English, and I was like, that almost is a better theme than the movie itself has.
Right. Yeah. No, it's almost more
thoughtful of the like. Foreshadowing that like this is what it's supposed to be for. It's not really gonna be about this. It's gonna be about America.
Yeah.
Or about American.
Yeah. Again, and he comes back to town, back to the village, and he gets sidelined by one guy.
Yes.
I don't know.
We can't remember.
Again,
neither of us could figure out who that was.
Again, my best guess is that he's the blacksmith because he's so big and he gets a. Actually, Greider actually gets a shot in, and the guy just keeps going.
Mm.
Yeah. American sound effects. Thank you so much. He gets sidelined. He gets hooked with an actual hook in the shoulder, and then Lucas actually shows up. Deus Ex Machina's him.
I did like that. That was
and
nice.
Yeah, that's,
that a, very,
that's an empowerment.
I thought that was a very America's nod to the British in World War II kind of moment.
Right. Let's go with that metaphor, I guess.
Don't go with that.
Okay. Yeah, but yeah, he shoots the guy basically in the back.
See, it is a little.
He shoots the guy in the back, and Greider is still alive, and he's. Is just here to finish the job, basically, which is old Brenner. And he goes up to his house. There's nobody there anymore except for the women.
And
yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And old Brenner himself. And he...
This is very dramatically at the door.
Yeah.
I could have done without that, honestly.
That was
like
a bit too long.
It was like a 7 to 10 second shot of a door.
Yeah.
I was like, this is not a student film. We understand. There's tension.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah, but I'm trying to be alternative, man.
I got it.
Yeah.
Like, right? Like, I was...
Yeah. Okay, so he points at the door and... He
stands at the door.
Yeah, the guy...
Opens the door.
Yeah.
He approaches the door.
Yeah, exactly.
Door
yeah,
happens.
old Gran is in
all
there.
All the door things happen.
Yeah, and we get the final conclusion that he knows that he's the son of the girl that he raped, and that he's technically the father of old Brenner is technically the father of Greider, and Greider gets very emotional, and then the other guy, old Brenner, knows that he's gonna die, so.
Yeah.
He's just getting shot in the back.
He points the gun at himself.
Yeah,
inside.
Yeah,
I was impressed by that, by the Joseph metaphor.
Oh, yeah,
I was very impressed by that.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
Mm-hmm. And then he has, of course, troubles with his wounds, but I guess that was just tacked on.
That was one of the things where I was like,
they could have done without that.
Yeah, and it's not the...
Because we
realistic.
Already know
of
that he's so
survived. Of course he could be in pain, but I mean...
Yeah,
I didn't feel like it added to anything. His character...
It would have added something if he had, like, the wounds and then died.
Right, no, that would have been a very different movie.
Also,
but
that would be a
die,
very Austrian...
But he was sick
Austrian
for 3 weeks.
Yeah, that's also a very Austrian ending, to kill
yes, that
the
was
main
almost
character.
What I was expecting that, to
yeah.
the very end. I was like, when is the German going to kick in? Like,
I need a shot of German.
Like, when... It was very American. The hero just lived. He got sick for 3 weeks. That is American. Like
Then he's just good to go.
He was sick. He had to get shot.
Not even a disability. Not a lost leg. Nothing. Just a little bit of fever. Ooh.
Oh, fever for 3 weeks.
Ooh, yeah, so bad. Especially during the winter, where there's ice everywhere.
I thought that was interesting. It was very. I did feel it was authentic because he had been so American all along. I was glad that he didn't stay because I think that would have been not. That would have been very weird. Not authentic.
Yeah, that would have been weird.
Yeah, because it was clear.
Even though he's an Aus from Austrian descent, he should have come back.
But he was very. I think that was kind of the point was that he was from Austrian descent, as all white people in America are from like Europe.
Yeah, exactly.
But he's like an American.
Yeah. Also played by an American. So, but again, I'm very impressed by his German.
You were making fun of it at the beginning.
Yeah, I'm still making fun of it in a weird way because it's just still an American accent, but. Like, the intonation and the way he spelled the words and everything was very well done. So he actually gets props for that. Like, that, there's especially in American movies, if they're Austrians or Germans, they sound horrific when they talk German.
Or they
talk in a German accent or an American accent or something
like that.
Yeah.
Have you ever heard Chinese or Japanese in American movies?
Oh yeah, nope.
I mean, I don't speak it at all, but like, I can tell it is wrong.
I watched enough anime to know that's just wrong what they're doing.
I had friends who in high school we would watch, and they would be like, born and raised in China, who were like, I have no idea what they're saying. she couldn't figure it out. She'd get half the words, maybe.
Yeah. Oh wow, that's bad. That's bad. That's
bad.
Really bad. Alright, yeah. So I think we're done with the plot now.
Yes.
Finally. That's probably not getting done here. No, that episode has to be done quickly. So let's move on to cinematography. Just in general, what do you think about the We talked about it at the beginning with the wide angle shots and everything.
And
you were pissed off by the rain and by the snow.
The rain, I was very disappointed.
Yeah.
I just thought that was terrible.
All right.
I thought the effect was terrible. That's all there is.
We can
move on, but that was all right.
Yeah, that's it's a quick segment normally. So
that rain was terrible.
But
and
otherwise,
anything
exceptional.
Obviously, the mountains. The Alps.
Beautiful. It's well shot.
Yes. My biggest kind of query, concern, just criticism, really, was...
You mean quarrel?
Criticism.
Okay, alright. Yeah.
I guess quarrel. Was there were several fade to blacks.
Oh, yes, I noticed that
did
too.
I,
they did like
there were
four
a
or five
yeah,
of those.
Including, and questionably placed. I'm not a fan of fade to blacks
in general,
in a movie that's not made by a college student. I just don't think it's great. But
it's lazy, that's what it is.
Exactly, it's very lazy. It's a way of saying, this is now a moment that should mean something to you. And if you didn't get that from my shot, from the dialogue, from the acting, from the light, from anything else, I'm going to literally just tell you now.
Yeah, exactly.
And they had a lot of them. But even those were questionably placed. One of the first fade to black that I remember that I noticed was when the girl and her fiance, boyfriend, whatever, are literally rolling in the hay.
Yeah.
She says, we've got to wait till we're married, aren't we?
Yeah.
It's a fine scene. It's not an interesting scene. It's been in Dawson's Creek.
Yeah.
It's fine,
here too.
It's been in Dawson's Creek. It's been in Gilmore Girls.
Yeah.
Like, it's fine here.
But I accept for that the fact that I kind of expected boobs or man butt because that's just an Austrian thing to do.
Mm.
Yeah. Because, you can have an over 16 movie or an over 14 movie, depending on the context. And have boobs and butts in there.
Right, that's very true.
Yeah.
But again, the pandering.
True. Or maybe they just wanted to be, they are both so innocent and they're Romeo and Juliet in a very fucked up situation.
As opposed to Romeo and Juliet?
Yeah, well,
we're not.
They were at least rich,
That's true.
Yeah, those guys are poor. Getting oppressed by randos and getting raped. Nobody's raping Juliet, I think.
Yeah, probably not. Honestly, honestly, you're right. Nobody's
yeah.
No, but the fade to fair enough. But for the most part, the essence of the scene, it's a teenage girl being like, "Not yet, we're not married," and him being like, "I really like you, but I have a boner." Like,
yeah,
I mean, which is a fine scene, but it wasn't original in any way.
Yeah.
But they faded to black off of it. That was the thing.
Yeah.
And I was like,
but nothing happened.
I was like, what about that?
Yeah.
If you are going to use a fade to black, what about that deserves that?
Yeah. Yeah. That's
like, you
true.
Really need us to contemplate teens are horny.
Yeah. Oh.
And conflicted.
Who would have thought? Well, extra conflicted in that case, because if she got pregnant and she and old Brenner knew about her being pregnant because it's a village, then, oh, fuck. That's not cool, because he knew that it's not him.
That's true.
Or his
sons. That's very true, but he did know that it was very... But also, they did know it was very close to the wedding. I see your point, and I think that that's actually what they were going for. To me, it was kind of undercut by the fact that it was unclear when exactly
maybe
the wedding
was
happening.
Maybe a hymen thing, too?
True, although she rode horses. Although, I guess she was riding side saddle, wasn't she? So, never mind. Take it back.
That's good thinking right there.
Yeah, no, actually, that's good. I mean, that's good on their part.
So, cinematography in general, decent to exceptional, and some blunders.
I would say some absolutely exceptional,
mm-hmm.
and some very not pleasant, not good. Not even good. Just kind of mediocre. Disappointingly mediocre.
Yeah.
Not even bad. Just disappointing, because there was some incredible.
Yeah.
Cinematography.
Yeah. It
fluctuated
quality, so much
exactly.
that it was.
Exactly. I don't think I would have minded any of it if it had been like the all consistent. But because
right.
I saw there were like some amazing parts, I was
yeah.
like, this is shoddy.
Yeah. Exactly.
I wouldn't
yeah.
have even noticed it in maybe another movie.
Yeah.
It's not super fair, but, you know.
All right. Yeah, no, fair point. All right, so let's move on to our next segment, and that's going to be music. So we already talked about the entry song, which was American music, but they had some classical music in there as well, like classical pieces just for background music, and they used the... fucking sound from Inception, which I was not okay with, because that felt so like, again, pandering, I guess. Like, there was a sound engineer who was like, "Oh yeah, that's the cool new thing. They did it in Inception."
When did this movie? 2014. Okay.
Yeah. So Inception was 2012.
Oh, so it was very. So that was okay.
Yeah.
So they were doing that. Okay.
Yeah.
But it was very. Oh.
Yeah, so in this case, they
were in the studio while
yeah.
that was at its height. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so
yeah,
they were like
right.
just, oh yeah, that's that we
yeah.
have to do that.
Wow. All right.
Yeah.
That actually.
And so
makes it
and
that
so many
about the
and
timing.
So and so many movies just doing it right now.
Yes.
Yeah. So yeah, we have that in there, but the rest of the music is, I think, very.
I think it was very good.
Yeah.
In general.
Yeah,
in general.
I could listen to the songs just on their
yeah.
own.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
And,
okay.
and that you can always do that with classical music, especially
yeah.
if you're like this. There's a lot of stuff that you're like, I can
right.
listen to maybe 20 seconds and then I'm done.
And
they had good picks.
And they reduced the dramatic music just to a few points in the movie. Like, there's a lot of non... Like, the shootout didn't have music.
I was very pleased. I thought that was very good.
Yeah.
I was
didn't have like
very,
a DMX song
yeah.
in it, like X gonna give it to you or something.
No, you're right. I did know. I think
yeah.
that's a really good point. That does separate it. It's
yeah.
not as an American movie. It'd be hard to picture. I mean, you could have like 45 seconds. I feel like max of a shootout in an American movie without some kind of music.
Yeah, yeah. They're just gonna put some
yeah,
pumping.
Yeah, pump something.
Pump. Yeah, pump it
yeah,
up.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, not that song.
Yeah, that was what I was going to complete it with. I know it's not going to be that song, but that's the theme. But I did, yeah, that's a good point. I did feel that differentiated it a little bit.
Yeah. So,
nice.
Well done on that
yeah,
part.
Yeah, well done, yeah.
Yeah. So
the end part, I mean, I actually thought it worked well.
Yeah.
At the end with the like, techno, disco.
Oh, yeah.
Was funny. I mean, ultimately, I thought it worked very well.
Yeah.
But when it first came on, I was just like, are we in a nightclub? Like,
yeah. No, there's a disco ball
was,
dropping down.
But
and
ultimately, it actually totally worked, and I was like, I take it back, this was good.
Yeah. Yeah, and they faded into the credits,
yeah.
which
yeah.
was very nice.
Yeah.
So
I
yeah.
ultimately, I take it back, but at the beginning, it was, I think I wrote down, I wrote, what is this? Why is there disco? That's what I wrote down. I'm like, that's the whole
Right on. So let's move on to our second to last. Well, we are halfway there with the segments, and yeah, this is a long ass episode.
I talk a lot.
Yeah, same thing here. It's bad matchmaking, right there. So we're gonna move on to our third to last segment, and that's best moments. And yeah,
I get your. I want your opinion first, actually.
Okay. My
You're
best.
You're like so ready. I love that.
Oh yeah. So
for
my
anybody
best.
Who can't see him, he is like sitting up, like straighter.
Yeah.
He's like.
Yeah, yeah.
He's
okay.
Like sitting back and.
Just. Okay. So my best moment, I think, just because you know, I even though this place like 120 years ago, 130 years ago, I was still feeling the Austrian vibe to a certain point. When
You're
they
very
had
vocal
the
about that.
Yeah, when we had the schnapps drinking scene. Yeah.
Schnapps drinking scene.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'd use that verb.
Well, yeah, force feeding scene, I guess. So Kreider gets invited for a drink by one of the Brenner boys, and he refuses because reasons.
Americans or Puritans? I don't even know.
That wouldn't even make sense.
No,
he's like a Western guy to begin with. They drink. They drink all the time.
Being sarcastic.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah.
Puritans were like 200 years old.
Yeah. he had a wig on.
He refuses the drink for no reason.
Yeah,
like,
exactly. Just to
piss. Be a dick.
Yeah.
He was a dick.
Yeah.
Don't be a dick.
Yeah, and the Gradle boy was not happy with that decision and started to beat him up, and then when he was knocked down on the floor, force feed him the schnapps.
Yeah.
Like he said if I buy a drink, you drink it.
Yeah.
That was big finishing line. And then one of the Gradle boys when they left the bar, started to laugh like a maniac, and that happened again. That was twice in the movie,
funny.
And that was, I think, it was so out of place, but still hilarious.
It was funny. Though.
Yeah, like they have the maniac brother, and I think that wasn't even in the notes of the script. It was just the actor. Like, I need this. I need to be noticed.
I know. I feel like you're right. I totally think you're right.
Yeah, but still entertaining.
Yeah, very. And I guess I'm not sure if it was my favorite. I don't know if it was my favorite moment, but I could tag. I will tag on that and say that my favorite line of the entire script was at the very end of that. He walks out. He's on. You know, Grider's on the floor, dying ish. Not really, but
really drunk.
Really like choked.
Knocked out.
Yeah. And the guy and one of the Brenner boys says, "Put it on my tab."
Yeah.
And. that was my favorite line. I was like, I sometime in my life I want to be man enough to
do
that. That's a thing. I don't have to choke a guy first, but at some point I just want to say it.
You
that
just
cool.
want to ovary up.
I just
want
to sound like that cool to be like.
Yeah.
Put it on my tab.
Yeah. Nice.
I thought that was my favorite line.
Very
sure.
Very well played on your part.
Thank
now.
You.
Yeah. I got chills. All right. So what was your best moment? Do you have one now figured out, or are you still thinking about it?
It's difficult. Maybe when she stopped narrating for a
second. That would be favorite moment, not best moment, right?
Very, very fair. You definitely picked one of the best scenes. There were a couple other scenes that were very good.
The shootout was great again.
The shootout was the shootout. I mean, the shootout was excellent.
The horseshoe nails.
Yeah. Very. I mean, I liked. And in a way, I mean, I know it was a flashback, and so you have to be sparing with flashbacks. But I actually kind of wish we could have spent a little bit more time with his mother, with Grider's mother.
Right, because she's an interesting character too.
Very interesting, and I wanted they flashback, and then in the flashback, before. She's an adult or at least a teenager who's getting married.
Yeah.
She's a child.
Yeah.
Like a child.
Yeah.
And there was this vague touch on, you made the very, very good point about the literal in this kind of world, how literal new blood is.
Yeah.
Which I loved. But there was one line. There was something about young girls, which totally fits. I mean, obviously, old Brenner is he's a huge rapist. Like, it's not like we're gonna. He's a bad guy.
Right.
But that was an interesting kind of level of complexity.
True.
Because her parents, it seemed like it was hard to interpret, but her parents made some kind of, bargain. It did seem like her parents made some kind of bargain for...
Yeah. Her daughter.
Well, yes. Absolutely.
And definitely themselves.
For her. Yeah. Yes, for both. But not just for their daughter, for themselves, but it was more specific than I would have expected because they're depicted as so desperate. I mean, the line, I think, was about their hunger. They cried, they begged, but their hunger was worth more.
Yeah.
But even in that case, and they have a line about the young girls, even in that case, nothing happens until she's of age.
Yeah.
And she's going to marry, she's going to marry somebody. And in that case,
Was that their try of humanizing old Brenner? Was that like their way of saying he's still a human even though he's a stone cold asshole murderer?
I don't think that's what I mean. Like, you mean by the film?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Now I'm thinking about it. If it was, I think it was bad.
I hope it wasn't
because
it was so shallow. Yeah.
Like the very good man doesn't rape the prepubescent girls but waits till they're like 16.
It was just self-serving on his part. Like, I like big boobs,
yeah.
And that's not happening with that age.
Austrian girls, never
gonna happen.
No, I know beer wenches.
Especially in Tyrol. Yeah, that's definitely a thing.
I know.
Yeah.
But.
Hey guys.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. We are doing a recording right now, so yeah, no problem.
But I did think that I thought that was very interesting with that they could make a compromise.
Right.
On behalf of their daughter, knowing all these terrible things, knowing she's gonna be raped, but not until.
Yeah.
I think that's always interesting. I mean, it's any kind of. The great evil that you look at. It's any kind of serial killer, Charles Manson, like Nazis, like, what's his name?
Tell me.
Like all this, no, I was going to do serial killer, another serial killer.
Oh, okay, alright.
I know the name of a lot of Nazis. Yeah. I didn't have to think about that.
I'm there.
I am Jewish. It's from birth.
You're indoctrinated by that, in a good way, though. No, as somebody from Austria, it's a good thing that's being preserved. That
but
kind of, being
I didn't mean to turn
cautious.
I didn't mean to turn this into a non-denial of the Holocaust.
Yeah. Yes.
See, that
even though Austrians even back then were very anti-Semitic. If they had like. Jewish.
You mean even during the Nazi times, Austrians were anti-Semitic? So lonely.
it's still a problem now, It's so bad. Like in the second district of Vienna, like there's still
a lot.
That's
very shameful because in America, we had slavery and racism is gone.
Yeah, good one.
Thank you.
An anti-racism joke by two white people.
Yeah.
Yes, white power.
Oh my god.
Oh, that was.
I'm Jewish. It's fine.
Yeah.
They don't like me.
No, it's not good.
I'm not good, but I'm not them.
I'm once removed from evil.
I benefit from everything.
Neighbor
else,
of the beefs.
At least I would have been killed. That's terrible.
Yeah, it's so bad. But let's go back to the. So that was the flashback. Was your best moment? That scene with
the
girl.
Yeah, the little girl.
Yeah. Look, we brought it back.
Yes.
To the.
Well played.
Yeah, it's years of practice as a host of different podcasts.
Cool.
Yeah, it comes with age.
Good.
I'm so old. No, it's yeah. just my younger brother is 10 years younger. And
oh, okay.
So
oh,
yeah,
a lot
it's
younger.
It. So hmm.
Yeah, but that's quite a bit younger.
Yeah, so there's
you
just.
You have the same mom and dad.
Yeah, yeah.
Interesting. Afterthought child.
Hmm.
Afterthought child. They got a little more in the fifth grade.
No,
they were like,
no, they yeah. it would be fourth in Austria, but yes.
Mm.
Yeah, you go to school with six normally. But yeah.
But yes, this is your agreement.
Yeah, let's turn this into my story. But no, they were just, you know, another child would be nice, kind of way. Yeah, worked out perfectly. Great brother.
So how old is your brother?
Huh?
How old's your brother?
Oh, you want to know my age? Ah!
I already know your age.
Huh?
I already know your age.
What?
No, I don't, but
okay.
I
stalked you. Oh, what?
You Googled me.
I'm in your home
set.
Now,
like
and then you stabbed me. Huh? What?
You Googled me and watched my set. I mean.
That's true. Yeah, I did watch your set. And come on, that's just good preparation time. I just wanted, you know,
if I didn't think
you were funny, I was like, oh yeah,
I mean, I couldn't
do it at that
on
time.
On your part, that's very good preparation. On my part, I texted my friend. I was like, so I'm going to do this Austrian comics podcast somewhere like really deep in Bed-Stuy. And if I am murdered on Craigslist, you know what? I swear to God, that's actually not my
fault. Oh, nice.
I just want someone to know. Like, I don't need them to remember
good thinking.
My murder,
good
but
thinking.
I just want them to
good
know
thinking.
About
no,
it.
No, no, no. Men are so much more vicious. You know, you should be on your toes. Yeah. And you would have, if I turned out to be a serial killer, you would have had a perfect moment to have put it on my tab. Like we are sitting at a bar right now. Like you smash my face against the bar,
oh my God,
I collapse, and you're like,
very good point. Very good point.
Put it on the tab, and then
you
live.
And you watch my set, so you know that like I can't die because that
yeah.
would just be depressing.
Yeah, really depressing.
Right?
Yeah, so depressing.
I know. I think about that sometimes. Like, you know, I'm not really that worried about being murdered. I'm just like, the odds are not in favor of it. Like,
the,
how
yeah, yes.
likely is that
yes,
that would happen
yeah.
to my parents
no,
twice?
No, you should start playing Lotto.
I don't feel like that's in the cards, but I
no, either you get murdered. It's a 50-50 chance in that case. Either you get murdered or you win the lottery.
So you're not good at math.
No, so bad. So bad.
It's okay. Most
yeah.
people I work with
oh,
my
dad
too,
is my dad
they...
is so disappointed that I'm not good at math.
That's so Austrian.
He's very disappointed. Yeah, he beats me
it's
with
okay.
a ruler. He
it's
thinks
okay,
that, he thinks that the centimeters are turning into real numbers in my head. He beats me by the centimeter. Okay. No, my dad
so
was just a lovely person.
Yeah, I assume.
Best friend I ever had.
Yeah.
Nice. No, especially when I was like 16, because there's not a lot of age difference between us. He was 23 when he got me.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So,
oh, yeah,
so when
young.
I was 16, people
was like
thought 20, we were brothers.
39.
Hmm?
Wait, you were 16. He was. He was 20. Oh wow, he's 39.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well,
that's
he
young.
Was.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah
he was.
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah
so we people thought we were brothers.
Yeah.
It was so fun, and he still looks amazing for his age. Like, I'm so happy that I have his genes.
I understand. My mom
yeah.
looks... She finally is starting to look a little bit her age, but, like,
yeah.
she got carded until she was 45.
Oh, we're so turning away from the
sorry,
mad at
we
hand.
Are. Oh, my
yeah.
God, we are. This is, you know,
oh,
the host, oh, it's your
responsibility. Yeah, that's why I'm turning it, turning the ship around again to lead to our final segment. Because my best moment finally happened, and the second to last one is a very special segment for the U.S. in
yes.
this case, and that's American exceptionalism. Mm. That's a mouthful.
We are exceptional. I'll say that. All right, this I have to go through my notes because I took a lot of notes on this.
Yeah. Yeah, but we talked about that. Like, he has the superior armor.
No,
armory.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Okay, what?
I mean, that too, but
yeah.
I was just... I have... Let's see. Austrian movies have weird stuff on the left side of the screen.
What? What do you mean by that?
They're those weird gadgets that you are so obsessed
with. Oh, yeah, well...
I understand those are not actually...
Yeah, that's...
Yeah.
The TV just being a dick.
See, that you can edit out.
Yeah.
See?
I'm not gonna edit that out.
I'm giving you examples.
You're so obsessed with having the perfect experience in under 30 minutes. It's not gonna happen.
I don't know if you could ever get this in under 30 minutes.
You know, Europeans, we take our time. We that's like, you know, the we'll whole see. Cliche about laugh making, yeah.
That's out of a Simpsons episode. and then Perry did it on Family Guy.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah.
Their saddlebags are gorgeous. Yeah. Leather. Oh my god.
Looking good, right?
Beautiful. Vogue would kill. Sorry.
Yeah.
Vogue
would kill. Nice.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna murder them for their good looking
okay,
saddles.
The palest cowboys I've ever seen.
Yeah, because.
Seriously, it's like Mr. Darcy and Paul Bunyan. You fuckers don't know who Paul Bunyan is, do you? That's what I wrote down.
Nice.
It is weird. There's some interesting clashing of attire, and I'm not an expert in... I like history, I'm not an expert in history, but I do love, like, historical clothes.
Right.
And there was some interesting blending that I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, no, it's... The men with the
they had some neck garments that I was like, that is like at least 75 years behind your time.
Yeah. Well, again, we are in a mountainside where they use tools and techniques and weaponry that's like at least 50 years behind the times.
I totally said that with weaponry and tools, but with
fashion, it's a bit
different because that's the thing is that it's not as though they're wearing an overcoat.
Yes,
that's fine. Like, clearly, that's about utility.
Yeah,
but they have neck scarves. That I'm like, there's no reason for that other than fashion.
Tyroleans, there are some neck scarves going on in Tyrolean fashion in general, but I couldn't pinpoint from what era right now. So, like, for example, the classic garment that is still worn today for like beer fests or special events like Sommerfrische, which is like the first week or something of that, like during the summertime where the first time where it's really nice out and stuff like that. I guess they still put it on. And politicians love to put it on to go
like
to
Americans
like
Americans going to a diner. It's the same.
Yes, or exactly. Eating obscure local food or something like that. Yeah, it's the same thing there, except it's only beer drinking and wearing that. That's all you have to do. Drink a schnapps or two, then you're golden. That actually killed our last, our second to last right wing party leader, alcoholism. He just drove into the wrong direction and his car flipped over and he died. And there was this conspiracy theory that the Mossad actually contracted the kill, which turned out to be bogus, of course, but still hilarious. Like 48 after his death, they were like, oh yeah, by the way, the Jewish people did that because he was very, you know.
We're not great. We do kill a lot of people. We don't even do that. We're not good at it. It's not like the Americans. Like the Jews, honestly, I'm an American and I'm like, yeah, my...
Palestine would have been gone, but not if the Americans were there. Yeah, that's not a very touchy subject.
I can't know. I mean, it's touchy only because my Jewish relatives would hear me be like, dude, we fucked the fuck up. It's my whole opinion.
yeah, it would be nice if they just stopped bombing each other.
Like, I understand, like, we've been bullied for thousands of years, and so that's natural to, like, want it, but stop.
It's a knee-jerk reaction.
But you have
really fabulous tanks, though. Israel has one of the best tank designs.
And no good athletes. You have such good soldiers, and you'd think that would translate. It's
nope.
Not even a little.
The only thing that translates in Austria in that respect is skiers.
I think it's the fact that we can't play on Saturdays.
You just have one day less of training.
I think that's a problem. I think that's
an issue. Yeah, that's true.
It's an important game day.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Okay, we're very off track again.
American exceptionalism.
Oh, okay. Why do they have such huge spoons for such shallow bowls?
Right, or at least more stuff in the bowl.
No, just specifically very oversized spoons.
Yeah.
Bigger than the width of
his lips. Yeah, yeah.
Than the width of his lips. The bowl was very clearly, they showed multiple times, less than a half an inch deep.
I don't know. I don't know. Because actually, that silverware, I think, would be more used as a cooking spoon than.
It's made of wood.
Hmm? What?
It's not silverware, because it's made of wood.
Oh, yeah, right. Right. Damn.
I'm calling you right now. Okay, never mind.
Yeah. I can edit that one out.
See?
Yeah, I'm
See,
not.
I told
but
you.
Yeah, let's get this done with.
Yes. Okay.
Yes,
oh,
American.
He was wearing Burberry at some point. I noticed that.
Really?
Yeah.
Like you saw that in a shop or something?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, that's funny.
It was a very distinctive collar.
Okay.
They vary into the liquids up close. Is that an Austrian thing? Or is
liquids
that just
up
movie?
Close?
Yes.
Like the water?
Like anytime there was an important scene, there was a liquid and then there was ice breaking and I understand.
Ooh, that's a good. That's
thing,
good.
It was a lot of times.
Not that I've noticed up to this point, but drinking is always a big aspect. That
but
yes, but
water breaking ice mostly, not alcohol.
Water breaking ice is definitely a mountain movie kind of thing.
Yeah.
When you have something like you want to see the natural forces colliding with each other,
right.
Like the liquid is stronger than the hard stuff or something like
they
that.
Did it a lot, like 7 times.
I think that just the B team just got a few good days in of those shots and they were like, we have to use that stuff, like, and the editor is like, oh god damn it, okay, all right, we're gonna put in one more, and the guy, what about this one, this is also amazing, let's put this one in as well, and he's like, oh, all right, and he just compromised.
I think you're right. They
because they could have trimmed that movie by like 20 minutes.
30. But I agree. No. I agree. God, she should have stopped narrating. They had very big collars.
Yeah. Popping those.
That was our thing, I know, right?
Yeah. Well, at least there wasn't one in a fishtail.
That's true. That's very
suit
fair.
Or something. Contemplating. Yeah.
There are so many.
But again, it's American exceptionalism.
Yeah.
En grandeur or something like that. My French is so bad. I had 6 years of French.
I was a bit confused by. I know that it's not about the Jews, but I was a bit confused.
No, it wasn't about the Jews.
I said that.
But
that's what I just said.
Yeah, I know.
That's what I just said.
Yeah.
I was a bit confused. So, like, do you think that if they'd had smaller currency, she wouldn't have been in that position of choking? Like, I was a bit...
The old lady! We totally missed that part during the plot scene. But,
so
dense.
I was a bit, like, she looked so unable to do it, like it was going to kill her. And I was kind of like...
That's a decent
size part. I
mean, it must
be big. It must be really big. But, like, so does that mean, like, if money had been smaller, it would have been fine. It would have been like an uneventful scene. Like, would it even be worth it?
Yeah, he's like, the next one is just the paper money, and you can just shoot it.
Pennies, like, kids eat, like, 20
of
those.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's fine. Like.
Well, it was an American dollar. It wasn't a gold dollar.
I know, but, like, stacked away, though, it's gotta be, it's a lot bigger than that.
Or she was just stingy and just thought she could just keep it by spitting it off.
Trying to make it about the
Jews. Yeah. But eating the gold thing, that was actually a thing that tribes did with, like, the Spanish
people.
So,
the Inca, the
just pour gold, liquid gold in the mouth.
Game of Thrones.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was a hat, but still.
I know.
Yeah. Yeah, so, he's the hero of the whole story. He has a tale of vengeance. That's very much American exceptionalism right there.
Fair.
Yeah, he's the protagonist. He has the best gun in the whole East, I guess, in this case.
Yeah.
It's not the Wild West. It's the very, very rural East of all.
I only thought of this at the very, very end of watching the movie. And I do think it's a good movie. I did think it was interesting. It's a movie I mean, that's obvious. Like,
yeah.
I mean,
yes.
Non-debatable. It's all about it, from
yeah.
the first to the last shot.
Yeah, the reason of
the whole
journey.
Yeah.
Yes,
that's
everything.
Clearly, that's why he's there, to avenge
yeah.
his mother. He saves the...
Right.
For a movie that's all about rape, it had... And has a female narrator.
Hmm?
And it has a female narrator.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. We have her perspective for a good part of the movie.
Yeah. I felt like it had nothing to do with rape at all. It was... I'm not saying that in like necessarily in a critical way.
Yeah.
I just think it's an interesting way... Like, it's interesting to think about it because it's... Only
well, in this
because
case
the movie is so centered around rape.
Yeah.
But
it's
the,
also
the emotion is only about him. It's really
right.
about vengeance. It has
yeah.
nothing to do with like
true. Yeah.
Any of the women in the plot.
It's just
the
drive.
It's
a just the drive.
It's not necessarily a bad thing, like
yeah.
at all. I
yeah.
think it's a good movie for him.
Yeah.
Like
oh yeah.
He's
a great actor.
Yeah, no, and that's not that that's a problem, but I did think it was interesting just that they were so focused on it.
Mm.
It was so constant. I mean, like the imagery, and there was, I mean, it was,
yeah.
it was brought up literally. It was brought up. I thought that was interesting. That by the end, I was like,
but they never showed it.
None of the actual, and that's
yeah,
yeah that too.
They never showed it, and it was also in this case, I guess one step further because and also more dehumanizing to a certain extent. I think at least. In that case, in that it is institutionalized rape, because
right.
they are the Brenner boys and the
right.
old Brenner are the institution that rules everything.
That
they are God.
Yeah. Yeah.
They are God
right.
in the end.
Exactly. And I like that they're depicting that, but I did think it was interesting that in the victory, and again, it's not that there's anything wrong with this. It was just because I wouldn't even have thought of it if it weren't for the fact that it was so much. Imagery and like
yeah.
they really
pushed the subject.
It wasn't just that he was like
yeah.
avenging his mother or like avenging his father's. It was very like from the moment he met the first girl, like it was
yeah.
very, very,
very clear. Yeah.
Yeah, but it was all about his. I think he's the main character, so it makes sense.
Yeah.
But it was all about his.
But
vengeance.
Maybe, and that was what I was thinking.
Yeah.
It wasn't his vengeance. It was her, his mother's vengeance because he didn't
right.
never could have known about it all.
Right.
She just told him all of that,
exactly.
And he's like the avenging angel to the lost soul,
yes.
basically.
Yeah, very, very, almost kind of St. Mary.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. yeah, yeah okay,
so,
yeah.
so I guess maybe it's a more of a metaphor into, in
yeah.
that part, and that he's just a vessel
mm-hmm.
that keeps her will alive,
yep.
and that what keeps
exactly,
his
yeah.
him alive by or him. His drive.
His, yeah,
his drive
his,
is his mother's
yeah.
vengeance.
Yeah, absolutely. No,
yeah.
exactly. No, that was exactly what I.
Which I thought, if that was intentional, was very smart.
Yes, agree. Absolutely. That was actually, yeah, exactly.
ah.
Yeah. No, exactly. I think that I thought that was very interesting because I keep saying interesting, which is
yeah.
a way of saying I can't remember what I'm gonna say next, but. I did.
Thought provoking.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Because the approach could come off as very shallow in one way,
mm.
or much deeper in another way, or again more shallow, or
right.
again even more thought provoking. You know.
Yeah, I totally get you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Again, great, just well done. I think it just a different take on the subject. Because
yeah.
there are, it's a horrible subject, but there are movies out there that
no, but
just
I appreciate
directly
it's
address
than others I've seen, which is
yeah.
that's in of itself an accomplishment.
Yeah, yeah, they different take on it. Yeah.
That in of itself is an
yeah.
accomplishment.
Very well done, exactly. So I think we're gonna finally wrap this up and come to our last segment, which is yeah, and now everything I'm gonna smash because that's how we do it at this podcast. Oh, surprise! Hammer. yeah, it's by the way, secret webcam over there. We are live casting this too. And that is final conclusion. Would you recommend this movie to other people? And if so, what's the main reason behind it for you?
I can be very judicious with movies that I recommend, but if you sure. I think that's a good summation. Sure.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, it's not out. I wouldn't put it as
like you have a party and you're like, let's watch a movie. It's not that kind of movie, right?
I don't really watch movies at parties.
Yeah.
I don't really throw parties, to be fair. Like that's on me. That's not on him.
Yeah.
But if I did, I don't think I'd watch movies.
Yeah.
But that's on me again. I think it's a movie that I would be like, if someone was like, should I watch this? And I was like, do you want to? And they were like, I was interested in it. Then I'd be like, absolutely, yes.
Okay, yeah.
But if someone asked me for like the top 5 movies they should see before they die, like it wouldn't be.
Yeah, no.
But even the top 50.
Yeah, but if you would recommend it as like a very light entry, for example, into Austrian movies.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, because it still has all the perks of being like... American centric.
I would refer them to you. I'd be like, I have somebody who's actually Austrian.
Yeah.
That would be my, I would honestly be a little hesitant to recommend it on that reason, because I would be like, I would feel a little bit like I'm recommending like maybe a very American appealing kind of movie.
Yeah.
So I might,
just too
honestly,
pandering.
I might ask you first.
Okay.
I might be
all
like,
right.
Let me ask him if there's a better. I feel like you would know better. That's bad.
Yeah,
that's bad.
But otherwise, if it would pop up on Netflix,
yeah, oh yeah, no,
yeah.
I enjoyed watching it.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Excellent. Yeah, for me too. I'm very taken by this movie actually because again, all the Austrian and German movies that had the Western genre in it, it was just they are all comedies. Like, one of the highest grossing German movies of all times is called The Shoe of the Manitou. Well, that's the literal translation of the title. I don't know if that's the American title as well, but yeah, that one is the highest grossing, and it has boner jokes and everything in it, and it's still a Western. It's a great movie. It's a great movie.
To be fair, this did have boner jokes in it.
Huh?
To be fair, this did have boner jokes in it.
Wait, where were the boner jokes?
Oh,
like the log,
the log,
or
no, that wasn't.
No, because he got wood.
I mean that too, but that was more me making that joke. That was my
okay.
But
all
no,
right.
But there was. Continue.
Yes. Yes, it is called final conclusion, not discussion.
Sorry.
Yeah. No, come on. It's fine. It's fine. You're the co-host, technically. again, it's one of the few truly Austrian movies on Netflix, so if you have American Netflix, like there's more stuff on Austrian Netflix, of course, but if you're in the US and you have American Netflix, definitely watch this one if you want to just get a really, really light entry into Austrian movies, and, well, gentle, I guess, but it, because it's the subject or anything,
gentle.
anything, anything about that movie is not light.
But no.
Yeah.
Like the
subject and everything
culturally,
is very heavy.
Culturally.
Light.
Right. Culturally, definitely.
Yeah.
Culturally, definitely gentle.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
No, that the movie itself is not gentle
yes,
at all.
Culturally.
Yeah. Very gentle. Very gentle. Yeah. Exactly.
Yes.
Yeah. Austrian light.
Yes.
Yeah, that was a joke. Call back. To something we didn't record.
But that's why I said it quietly before,
okay.
But now you made me say it
again. It's gonna be on there. Is there anybody else who has a final conclusion?
Yeah, I have a final conclusion. Yes.
Oh, secret guest! Oh
yeah.
My god!
Hello.
A wild Irishman appears.
Yeah, a sweaty wild Irishman.
Oh, right on. Okay, so please introduce yourself.
My name is Alan.
Right.
And I'm Irish.
Right on,
yeah.
Alan.
Yeah.
Watertown.
So,
do you want anything more? Or?
Yeah, give us your final conclusion.
Oh, final conclusion, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I thought the film was good.
You're exaggerating your accent.
Am I?
Yeah.
Well,
He's trying to over-Irish.
Like, if it's IMDb, it's a 6.8.
See,
if it's Rotten Tomatoes,
yeah,
it's a 65%.
All right.
And if it's Metacritic, it's a 57%.
But still a fresh.
So that's
still
that kind
fresh.
Of movie
still,
we watched.
Yeah, okay. A fresh.
But it's a fresh, good movie.
Yeah.
Has a quite a neutral ground that I'm coming from. I kind of thought it was great.
Yeah.
No, sorry. Good.
Good.
Yeah, we'll stick with good.
Oh, there were some great moments where you were like, ooh, like where he shot the priest's fingers off.
Yeah, no, like, he didn't need to do that.
He
you
shot
know?
Him in the brain.
The director.
Yeah, but he covered
know,
his
I'm
face.
Saying,
yeah.
The whole film crew
sorry.
Could have, they
sorry.
could have ignored, they could have not even thought about fingers, you know? But like, they thought,
that is
what?
A good fucking point.
Yeah, somebody,
thank you.
Because
but, like,
it
I
is in the film. Did sorry. Yeah.
But when you get attacked or shot at, what do? You put your hands up, don't you?
Yes.
But he shot.
No.
Yeah.
And they remembered the fingers, and the fingers got shot off, which was
that's actually a really good point.
If you watch this,
really
film, it's got that's sticking to me.
Yeah.
Right now.
Oh,
so yeah, I can remember that scene.
And the nail in the
you just get,
yeah.
And the nail. And the nail.
The nail.
I
was looking at my phone for the bit.
Oh.
I looked up just as it swung into his face.
Yeah.
Which was probably enough.
Yeah.
But I might watch that back later.
Yeah.
YouTube best off of the movie.
Yeah, yeah. But it was a good movie. Had had nice clips from a countryside point of view.
Yeah.
The apps look great. Even though it was probably filmed in Toronto.
Toronto.
Fuck off.
Don't pronounce the T.
Oh, that's a New York joke. Nice.
Don't pronounce the T. Toronto.
Toronto.
Yeah, I've been here 10 days and I.
Yeah.
I
it's
know
not an American thing. American.
Yeah, you were mostly hanging.
No, the Toronto joke.
And
Toronto joke.
And and you also were hanging out with an Austrian most of the time. So
don't tell my friends at home.
Oh,
I
you're gonna share this.
Here,
so yeah, no, the film was good.
Right.
The movie was good.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I didn't expect much coming from you, Paul.
And
Austria itself.
Yeah.
But it,
totally
it delivered.
Okay.
No, it was a good... How long was it?
An hour and 53 minutes.
Yeah.
Which is... Like, it didn't seem that long.
Oh, really?
I didn't think so. I wasn't taking notes. I was kind of...
Right.
I was kind of in and out.
Yeah.
That's true.
But I thought the film was good. Good acting, some good action scenes.
That's not gonna be the new blurb on the DVD cover. Alan says it's good.
No, but I agree. Exceptional action.
Yeah.
The shootout scene.
That was better than most American westerns by far.
Yeah, like I thought he was hiding in the roof of the cabin.
Yeah.
But he was actually hiding in
the floor.
Yeah.
I was very impressed.
You know,
because they did
impressed.
The wide angle shot up when he entered the one of the
bad
guys, and you thought, oh, he's going to be on top.
No, look,
American
I
directors are like so shitty about that. They're like, we're the only ones to notice shooting scenes. I'm like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen World War II? You're
not. But, like we knew he was going to die when he walked into the cabin.
Yeah.
But how he was going to die, that was still to be found out. And
yeah.
They, like, I thought one way happened the other, so impressive.
Right on.
Impressive.
Right on, Aaron.
Another couple points. I probably still didn't quite understand the film, because I never really understand the
same.
Films.
I looked it up on Wikipedia.
So, yeah, so maybe in a couple weeks, when I look it up and I find out a bit more,
just
I'll get it
all. Just
the
one scene that I couldn't, I did.
Yeah,
like,
sure.
I couldn't understand what was happening. I missed a bunch of this dialogue, and you couldn't rewind it.
Right.
Yeah.
It wasn't my fault.
But,
I only looked that scene up.
Yeah. Definitely on my... definitely.
I mean,
my
also
fault.
On me for not understanding German.
Yeah, you all should be learning German, yeah.
But I thought...
It's such a beautiful language. And the worst thing is, if you learn German...
This guy
German,
Paul doesn't stop talking.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, that's why I have a podcast, fucker.
Oh, yeah.
So, the thing is, even if you learn German, you wouldn't understand those guys. Because they're talking in a very thick Tyrolean accent. So you still have to turn on the subtitles.
Lovely.
So what I thought
on
the subtitle issue, I've watched films or detective series that have a shit ton amount of talking, and it's you're like you're looking at the subtitles more than you are the
at the action,
the actual film, yeah.
The actual what's going on in front
problem.
Of you.
Yeah.
So you're looking at the subtitles, and blah, 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 blah. Oh, that's what she said. Okay, and they're over here, and you never actually look up at the actors,
yeah,
or actresses,
right?
Or so I thought this film had a minimal amount of dialogue, would you say? And you read.
That was a Europe thing.
You'd read. You'd read what the.
I guess so.
I was joking.
Arthouse film
cool.
In general.
You'd read what the what was said, and then the action unfolds. So they, I thought that was a really good balance.
Right on.
It was.
No, that's a very good point.
Yeah, it was English subtitled, but it really didn't seem like it.
No, I think
that's
a very
possible.
Good point.
Mm-hmm.
I think, and that speaks to your point about gentle introduction.
Yeah.
To, because there are.
Yeah, you are actually the
problems.
Test bed in this case for.
I mean,
yeah,
no,
because
I
it's
I
a, an Austrian movie
honestly,
for an American audience.
Yeah,
yeah,
and you are Irish. You really
so,
don't have any fight in this.
Exactly.
Yeah, and you still enjoyed it. So
yeah.
that's a good
yeah.
That's a good pegging.
I can't
system.
Wait to see what it actually was on IMDb.
It is. I think it's somewhere around there. I looked it up. So it is.
Yeah,
it
was
actually
nominated but didn't win.
Yeah. So that's fair. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, it's you know you were invited but you weren't invited but you didn't make prom king.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, prom corp and upcom.
Yeah.
Very that American reference. Well played.
Thank
is
you.
It weird that we have like that prom royalty is such a huge thing with us, even though
oh, yes.
our American
oh, yes.
like political system is like that's like
it's
the bullshit.
It's so weird.
It's very big for
teenagers. We don't
it's
ever
huge.
Have that.
See, I think it's like a weird it's some kind of complex.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because it's
like there is best chosen, but they are chosen on a metric. Like you have to dance
know,
really good
still,
and
still,
stuff like
still,
that,
yeah, no,
and
I
you
know,
don't get
still,
a
like,
crown.
Wait,
what
you have that in Austria?
Yeah, balls are really big in Austria. Like balls are the
yeah, but like
you
your
say
high
balls
we're
are really big in Austria.
Your high
yeah,
school
yeah.
ball.
I'm sorry. Are we still recording?
That's
please include that.
Chronic.
Balls are really big in Austria.
Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, my family's
we love
from Ireland, they're bigger than Ireland.
No, we
any
have the biggest balls.
Yeah.
That's even an ACD song. Okay, alright, let's move on.
You just said ACD song, not ACDC song.
Oh, change. Yeah. Alright, we are getting off topic. So
back in sack.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
Oh God, that was awful.
That, oh my God.
What?
Yeah,
forget that
back
one.
Back to
the.
Yeah, go on. Back. Oh my God, really?
No, that was. Eject that from the memory.
Alright.
Really?
Okay, so final conclusion. A good movie.
I was in.
A watchable movie. Maybe not the maybe not the first thing you would think of to recommend
be the
somebody.
First Austrian movie I'd think of to tell someone
yeah.
to watch.
All right.
Can
but
you
it's
name
also
any other Austrian
yeah,
movies?
That's true.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's okay,
but
I
nonetheless.
Can't, I can't either.
Yeah.
I can't either. I'm not
yeah,
like
Yeah, I've been introduced to this.
Yeah.
I'm not
so saying. I'm happy to pass it on.
Right. Okay.
To the next
great.
Generation.
Pass the parcel.
So
yeah.
Definitely a recommend from the guys and from me. And
I'm
a
guy.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
Well, we're America. Everyone's
yeah.
guys.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Bros.
Yeah.
Hoorah.
I can do that deeper than you're Irish, but
yeah. Yeah. I'm pretty fucking.
You know what I can?
Oh, that.
I, you know what
the,
I can?
The microphone is
you know
not gonna
can,
pick that
I,
one up.
I can do it deeper than you.
Okay.
I can.
It's by the way,
it like
for the listener,
it
just it's
like
just grumbling.
Do
now,
your
like
best, chick. Impression.
Ah, oh, Jesus
you
Christ.
Do you watch professional wrestling?
No.
So you would know what you would sound like if you did.
Fuck.
Okay, all right.
See,
so,
that you can also edit out.
No, again,
please.
This is going to be in 1 hour and 20 minute podcast. This is so crazy. That's like 130 megabytes of data or something.
Just let me know when I come in so I can tell my friends.
Yeah, just,
at that point.
Just pop in at minute
so
120.
All my friends are going to be like, oh, this was his longest podcast. Oh, yeah, you were talking. That's not surprising. Like,
yeah, but the, you know, the same syndrome is happening to me as well.
But at least you host.
Yeah, I'm more to blame than you. just go, man. Okay, no. Oh yeah, we're doing plugs. Alan, please, your plugs. Where can people find you? Do you have some social media that people could follow?
Yeah, I do partake in the social media.
Yes.
If you'd like to follow me on Instagram.
You're taking a dab of the social media.
I'm just kidding, that's not a thing.
No, it's not. Media is the word.
Yep, you're correct.
Instagram, my name is Alan Fred. Do follow me with a pinch
of
salt.
With the
Do follow me with a pinch of salt because I get a bit creative at times.
He does.
But it's a record that he kind of waggled his hips as he said that.
Liar.
He has some good grams. He has some good grams.
Yeah, I got good grams. It is all about. I just like to be creative.
Yeah.
I like to express myself.
I'm just going to put it down in the description.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe my Snapchat as well. We'll talk about that later.
Come on. Just give us all of it. Give us the full Alan load.
Yeah, Alan. Oh no, load. Well, once you follow all these accounts, you'll be getting a serious,
a real deep Alan hole.
Yeah. What? No.
You stepped into
okay,
that
you
one.
Beer and I can't handle it. Like,
we're getting some Austrian schnapps.
that's necessary.
My snatch would be less tame, but it is Bubba J 101.
Bubba J.
Yeah.
You nailed 101. No
way.
B-U-B-B-A-J-101.
Nice. If you wanna add me.
Nice. That's a
introduce
killer
yourself
ass
and we'll go from there.
Alright.
Twitter is non-functional and my Facebook is
just a barren wasteland.
Well, not so, but
more crack.
There's more crack in the Instagram.
Crack the good stuff.
C-R-A-I-C.
Okay. All right. Okay. Julianna, your plugs. Where can people find you?
I'm so taken aback. People can find me. They can find me on Facebook. I am the girl with the name that's not spelled very well. Silent E, silent G, M-E-A-G-H-E-R.
Again,
just don't even try.
I'm going to put it in the description again.
Don't even try, honestly.
Yeah.
I'm also on Twitter, and I really have to change that because it's the same spelling there.
Right.
You can also Google me again with the same horrific spelling, and there are two YouTube videos. Watch them.
Right on. Yeah, you're on YouTube.
And my most important credit is that I am delightful.
Yes, you are. You were a gracious host.
I am.
Co-host.
Sure.
Very, very well done. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Just amazing that this happened. Again, first ever live. Well, not live, but, you know, American episode that is made in the U.S.
I'm very American.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to pay taxes on this one. I'm just happy to have you both here as guests.
I wonder how my laugh sounded there.
Okay,
oh, you. Oh, by the way, don't listen to your own voice because it always sounds shitty.
Mm.
Like, I sound like just... Yeah, exactly.
That's
yeah.
I thought that it was just my sexy
like
voice, but
okay,
apparently it's my all-time voice.
Mm.
Less cute Matilda, that's like my voice.
Yeah. So, so
let's do the musical and then you'll understand.
All right. Okay, let's put this baby down.
Is this a rap?
#, Alan Hole. This is...
Alan Fred. Oh, Alan Hole is...
Yeah, and thank you again for listening, guys, and thanks to you guys to be here.
Thanks for
thanks for hosting.
All right. See you soon.
Woo!